Councilwoman Barron, to salute the other public officials in the room. I'm not sure whether or not Hunter alumni dues have been paid, but I certainly know that the dues have been paid by Charles and by Inez, paying them forward, doing a great deal to advance the cause of the city, of education in the city, and the opportunities for young people in the city. And we thank you for that. We are pleased indeed to celebrate Hunter's distinguished alumna, Chair Inez Barron, to welcome her back to Hunter, where her longstanding connection with higher education began.
Thank you so much, Jay, and thank you for the honor of having this wonderful reception here. We're not sure, the historians can tell us, but we think we have the only husband to be followed by a wife in city council, and certainly the only double Hunter College alum. On our wonderful student alums. Inez was not just brilliant, but I think Inez is okay, we found your yearbook picture and you were quite, Inez Smith was quite beautiful. As beautiful as she was even smarter. She was an extraordinary student and she represented the best of Hunter. Thomas Hunter was a visionary educator who got kicked out of Ireland because his ideas were too progressive and he came here to create a school to train teachers because he believed in the quality of public education and creating educators who would create great citizens. And it was of that tradition that Inez studied in and went on to become an extraordinary educational administrator and teacher.
Thank you so much. I'm truly honored and humbled by this occasion that you thought that this would be appropriate for you to gather and to celebrate my getting the chair of the Committee on Higher Education. I first want to start by saying I give honor to God, who is the head of my life, and to whom I look each and every day to protect me, direct me, correct me, and favor me, because truly it's God's favor that has helped to move me to where I am. And I also join with those who've also said we need to pause and think about those who are suffering, who've suffered a loss, not only here in the city, but that plane that we just can't seem to find. So we just ask that you keep them all in your thoughts and in your prayers. I'm going to ask my husband to join me here. Councilmember Charles. This is the love of my life. This is the love of my life. My strong support, my strong tower, the person who always tells me I can do whatever it is I put my mind to. And not me alone, but any of the people that we know who call him with an idea. Charles, I was thinking he's right on board with supporting them and encouraging them in all of their aspects of thoughts and dreams and visions of what they want to do. Charles has set a great example as the chair of higher ed for the time that he was there, which is a part of the reason why people have such high expectations of me, in addition to what I've done on my own. The example, the road that he has paved, the fight, the determination, the insistence that CUNY be funded, that programs be expanded, and that it be meaningful to those of us who are trying to better ourselves. So I just want to say I love you, I appreciate you, you've set a bold path for me to follow, and I'm looking forward to that. One of the other important things about my time at Hunter was that it was free. If you went to New York City Public School and you had an 85 or better average, you were guaranteed a spot at City University. And that's the only reason that I was able to go, because my parents, both working parents, just didn't have that extra money for me to pay for tuition. I had to pay for books and travel and all of that, but they didn't have the money for tuition. So following with my predecessor, one of my goals is to look to see how we can get free tuition so that everybody who wants to go to CUNY can go to CUNY. I've heard all the stories about how the TAP covers a large percentage, but there are still others who want to go who cannot go. So I'm looking to see, I've talked to some of my colleagues, they have some interesting plans that they've shared with me to get some loan forgiveness and other projects like that, but I'm looking to see how that can happen. That's one of the things I want to do. I also want to look to see how we can get more scholarships instituted for CUNY's programs, for students who are coming. All kinds of scholarships are necessary for students to support them as they come here. I'm also looking for students. I've heard from students at three different campuses about a problem that they had in terms of having a dedicated space of their own. One of the administrators here talked about the diversity at their college and was very proud of that. We're very proud of that. We want the administration to reflect that as well as we go forward. Want to increase the number of full-time instructors so that students can have that ability to interact with someone that they know has office hours and is there and can support them as they go through. And also looking to increase the daycare and childcare services because so many of our young students and middle-aged students as well need that kind of assistance going forward. And one of the students from USS talked about additional subsidy for student transportation. All of these are doable. The money is in the budget. It's how we allocate the money that's already there. So we can look to withdraw Madison Square Garden's tax break that they've been getting all these many years. We can look to reduce what it is that we give away to other corporations. And we can find the money to put in those programs that benefit those persons who are here, struggling, trying to advance themselves and move forward.
Very excited. She gave a good speech today. She touched on a few things that she's considering as far as change within CUNY. I'm really excited for the free tuition idea or ways to allow students to come into CUNY who otherwise wouldn't be able to afford it. Very interested in her ideas for developing retention, bringing more students in and keeping them here. And a few other points she touched on were really interesting to me, so I'm very excited about it.